Hello everyone, Dr. Sasi Malik Sher here. As promised, I'm here to clear all your grammar problems and bringing easy peasy solutions to the things that you do not understand. The first and the most asked question by the students is the difference between which and that. And we are going to discuss this today. Let's take one example and see if we can put which there or that. The Earth is the only planet that supports life. Or, the Earth is the only planet which supports life. To understand the difference, first of all, we need to understand what is restrictive relative clause. I will call it the RRC. The restrictive relative clause is a very important concept to understand. It is that restrictive information about a preceding noun. Like we start our sentence, I'm talking about Earth. So there is going to be some information related to Earth in that sentence. That information is called a restrictive relative clause. And if I remove that information, that piece of information, the sentence is going to be incomplete. For example, the Earth is the only planet in our solar system that supports life. Now this part, that supports life, is actually the restrictive relative clause. Now let's see, what if I remove this part? It is going to become, the Earth is the only planet in our solar system. The meaning has changed. Instead of saying ki ye ek planet hai jo life ko allow karta hai, ab iska meaning ban gaya ki solar system mein ek Earth hi planet hai. So these are two different sentences. This information was the restrictive relative clause, which was giving the meaning to the sentence. So in a sentence, wherever we remove the restrictive clause, the restrictive relative clause, and the information given is removed, and that deteriorates the structure of the sentence or the meaning of the sentence, we use that in all those sentences. Now come the non-restrictive relative clauses. Jo sentences jin ke andar aisi information nahi hogi, jisko remove karke bhi agar hamare sentence ka structure same rehta hai, meaning same rehta hai, वहां पे हम which का इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं, who का इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं, whom का कर सकते हैं और whose का कर सकते हैं. Now there is a difference. Which is used for everything else, whereas who, whom and whose are to be used with the people only. So we can finally conclude that a non-restrictive relative clause contains an information that can be taken out of the sentence, maintaining the meaning of the sentence. So we use which in all those sentences जहां पे RRC को हम remove भी कर देंगे तो sentence का meaning same रहेगा. लेकिन अगर हम वहां पे information remove करेंगे और meaning change हो जाएगा तो वहां that आना चाहिए. Let's do a few examples. Now if you look at this example, the earth, this is the preceding noun जिसके बारे में बात हो रही है. इसके बारे में कुछ information यहां given है. This is the restrictive relative clause. Which is the third planet? Now I have to decide, is it a relative clause, restrictive relative clause or not? To see that, I will remove it. What if I remove it? The Earth, which is the third planet, supports life. Now, the Earth supports life. The meaning has not changed. So this is a non-restrictive relative clause. And when there is a non-restrictive relative clause, if we remove it and the meaning doesn't change, I will put a which there. Now see, if we put a that here, how would that look? The Earth, that is the third planet, supports life. It doesn't feel good. The sound of it is not good. You'll see, when we use a that here, it is absolutely incorrect because this part is not a restrictive relative clause and it can be changed. And without this, the meaning stays the same. Hence, that is not needed here. The last and most important thing is that you should always know that who is always used for the people. The boy who lives in Lahore. Then that can be used for people and things again with the restrictive relative clauses. Which is only used for the things. That would be all for today's lecture. I hope it was useful.